What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So I've scoured the web, put together all of the most pertinent information when it comes to Tesla's most recent acquisition of DeepScale. So that's what we're going to cover in this video. Let's get into it. So there are three main reasons why this acquisition is so important. But before we get into those, I just want to give you a quick background of the company. DeepScale was founded in 2015 by Forrest, Ian Dola, and Kurt Kutzer. In 2019, CB Insights named DeepScale to the third annual AI 100, which showcases the 100 most promising private artificial intelligence companies in the world. The company develops AI perception software for driver assistance and autonomous driving, with a focus on implementing efficient neural networks on automotive-grade processors. Essentially, they help automakers use less processing power, or wattage, to power more accurate perception. They're all about efficiency, and this is critical, as Forrest explains here.
I think the only exception I've seen really is Tesla's Level 2 system, where they've done some really great, you know, work redesigning neural nets to fit on small platforms, as well as developing their own platforms. But for all this stuff here, and pretty much the whole kind of self-driving R&D fleet, there's a trunk full of servers in these cars. If you ask the engineers at these companies what these servers are there to do, they say it's mainly for deep neural network inference. If you ask why they're doing that, they'll say, we're mainly using that for perception. So vis-a-vis, you know, perception with deep learning is the very expensive computing workload that motivates having these servers in there. But trunkloads of servers also have some major downsides. So obviously it limits the space you can actually store things in a trunk. They're quite expensive, so you can easily spend more money on the servers than you spent on the car itself. The energy usage is significant, so we're talking often 2 to 4 kilowatts. And if you look at how much energy you burn per minute while inching through traffic in the city or in a traffic jam on the highway, you don't burn all that much energy to propel the car at low speeds per minute. So you can easily reduce your EV battery range by double-digit percentage points, you know, in pathological cases, even up to, you know, 30-40%. On the highway, it's a lot less than that. And there are other issues as well with kind of filling your trunk with servers. So what are the solutions to this problem? Well, if you look at what kind of hardware people are putting in the trunk, it's often very high quality hardware from companies like NVIDIA. I love NVIDIA. I actually worked there briefly. I think they have some great products, but these products aren't for everyone. So they skew towards the more expensive end of the market with high wattage, pretty expensive devices, which their main benefit is that they offer tens to hundreds of teraops per second per board that you're putting in the vehicle, with things like Drive AGX or Drive Xavier. On the right-hand side, that's the kind of stuff that we actually can use in a vehicle that you or I would be able to go to a car dealer and purchase that has highly automated, you know, driver assistance in it. These are, you know, 1 to 30 watts, tens of dollars. Getting a teraop per second would be a pretty good accomplishment there. And, you know, I think the way most of the automakers I talk to see it, they could use, you know, one of these to process data from, let's say, 1 to 3 cameras each. So if you have 9 cameras, you're talking, you know, at most 9 of these chips, and ideally more like 3 of these chips. So this is a big gap. I mean, this is an order or two of magnitude, at least, kind of gap.
At the time of Tesla's acquisition, DeepScale had around 40 employees and was operating on approximately $20 million in venture capital. Financial details haven't been disclosed, but it's estimated to be around a $100 million deal, and we should get more information on Tesla's Q1 earnings report. 25% of the team at DeepScale have PhDs, predominantly in deep learning. 27 of them are engineers, and the team has more than 30,000 scholarly citations. And so this leads us right into reason number one, and that is the talent that Tesla has brought on with this acquisition. It literally cannot be overstated. Of course, everything I just mentioned, but I went through an interview that Forrest did last year, the co-founder of this company, and he was asked what his biggest problem was over the last 4 years. And he said it was finding and hiring top talent in the deep learning and the neural network field. So he's had to overcome all these issues of finding these people, and now literally in a matter of a couple days, Tesla's bringing all of that talent on board. There has been a transition recently from a hardware focus in Silicon Valley to a software focus, and there just aren't that many people in the world with expertise in the deep neural network field. As you may know, Tesla had lost around 10% of its autopilot software team over the last few years. Reports vary on the reason for the departures, but it's quite apparent that Elon does demand an absurd pace of innovation to be met, and those lofty expectations don't sit well with everyone. This acquisition is a breath of fresh air to the Autopilot software team and brings a ridiculous amount of experience and talent to the table for Tesla. As Forrest said, there aren't many deep neural network engineers in the world, and Tesla just brought 40 of them in-house. And so the second main benefit of this acquisition is the proprietary technology that Tesla now owns. So Forrest wrote a paper called SqueezeNet when he was in grad school, and basically this paper went viral in the neural network community. It basically says that they can put these deep neural networks on very small processors and they can use smaller chips, which is a huge deal, as you saw in the video clip earlier. Their research at the time was being funded by Ford, Bosch, Samsung, and a few others, and DeepScale got to work closely with these companies to learn the challenges they were facing with autonomous vehicle systems. This is what led to the creation of Carver 21, their proprietary software. It runs on very small processors and tells the car what's happening around it, and it's the first product DeepScale was bringing to market. Carver 21 captures vital information like the location of vehicles and pedestrians, where the lanes are, and a variety of other environmental factors. This software stack has been anywhere from 10 to 100 times more efficient than other industry applications, depending on the situation. The software system is also modular, meaning certain parts can be removed and used in conjunction with open sourced hardware. If a company had a great solution for lane detection, but didn't have enough resources to also build a pedestrian detector, that's where Carver 21 can solve problems. Forrest said in the interview that they've been able to create an AI system that learns to do something new in one day that would otherwise have taken months of training. For a simple explanation you can use in conversations, DeepScale will greatly help Tesla improve their computer vision accuracy in a much more energy efficient fashion, which further increases the effective range of the vehicles by requiring less power consumption from the batteries. And so the third reason comes down to data. To this point, you've probably heard that the company that acquires the most data will have the best chance of winning the full self-driving race. And now whether that data is real world or simulated is a conversation for another video, but that data is then filtered and sent into the neural network, which you can think of like the software or the brain of the operation, so that it can learn and process all of this information. If you take a second to think about the data Tesla is gathering from their nearly 1 million cars on the road, you can begin to understand the complexity and difficulty of learning and categorizing all of that data in an efficient manner. Tesla's enormous data advantage is more than enough to make any AI engineer giddy with anticipation of what could be. Tesla's sheer data and hardware excellence with their custom hardware 3 chip, I'll link the video to that in the description, paired with DeepScale's software and neural net expertise, it honestly seems like a perfect match. There's a SqueezeNet paper detailing the specific benefits they could have for Tesla. In the introduction, it says less overhead when exporting new models to clients. For autonomous driving, companies like Tesla periodically copy new models from their servers over to customer cars. We know this as OTA or over-the-air updates. Consumer Reports found the safety of Tesla's Autopilot has incrementally improved with recent OTA updates. But these updates of today's typical deep neural network models require huge data transfers. With AlexNet, which is the current iteration, it would require around a 240 megabyte data transfer from the server to the car. Smaller models would require less communication, making frequent updates more feasible, which is what everybody wants. With DeepScale SqueezeNet, they can achieve AlexNet level accuracy with 50 times fewer parameters. This means they can compress the data to less than 0.5 megabytes, which is 510 times smaller than AlexNet. And so yeah, this is just another example of Elon being multiple steps ahead of the competition, acquiring top tier talent that's gonna make a huge impact with regards to the speed of their full self-driving iterations, the over-the-air updates, the efficiency of this, lowering the cost, and all of those synergies coming together. It should be awesome. Once again, not something that's talked about much in the headlines, but behind the scenes, this is gonna make a real impact. And so with that being said, I thank you guys for watching this video, especially until the end. Hopefully I've earned a like, a comment, and a subscription. If not, let me know what I can do to make these videos better and more enjoyable for you guys in the future. I'm also open to any ideas or feedback of what you guys would like to see in the future. Definitely want this to be collaborative. But thank you, and I look forward to the next video.